Snub-nosed revolver, I'm going to give you 10 reasons why it is the handiest handgun you could ever have. You can always find a use for something like this. There might be better guns out there, but you will never have a situation where this couldn't come in handy. They're very handy, very useful. Now before I give my 10 list, I'm going to tell you, I've always had a thing for snub-nosed revolvers. In fact, my first centerfire handgun was a snub-nosed revolver, and that's simply because that's what I wanted. I wasn't concealing when I first got my first handgun. It was a home defense gun, but I had my own reasons why I really wanted a snub-nosed revolver. So I got a snub-nosed revolver. Now, these are very, very handy. Just like a pocket knife is very handy, these will always come in handy. And I'll give you my 10 reasons here. All right, a snub-nosed revolver. They will always have a place somewhere. And they'll always be useful. I mean, I can think of so many different reasons why this would be useful. I mean, if you can't come up with a better CCW option, this is pretty much a go-to for anybody. Not only that, but they're backup guns. They're good backup guns. And they're always going to have some place for usefulness. 100 years from now, even when people have laser guns, I'm willing to bet some guys will probably still have snub-nosed revolvers on their ankles. They're great backup guns. They really are. Number two, concealability and ease of accessibility. What I mean by that is this thing could be put pretty much anywhere, concealed anywhere. The pistol lockbox you would need to lock something up like this would be much smaller than other guns. You could put this into the tiniest little drawers. You could put it in the tiniest compartments in your car. You can put it pretty much in any pocket. And along with that, it makes a great house gun, because if somebody's knocking on your door and you don't know who it is, even in sweatpants, if you have an alloy frame 38, you can put it right in your pocket, answer the door, even have your hand in your pocket if you don't know who it is, very quick to come out if you need it. Very handy, very useful for that. Number three, the caliber selection is good. There's not as many caliber selections as there are for semi-automatic pistols, but there's a lot. You got your 22s, your 32s, varieties of different 32 calibers. You got your 38s and 357 magnums, 9mm chambered revolvers. You got your 40 chambered revolvers, 41 caliber, 44 calibers of different kinds, different 45 calibers, 50 calibers. I mean, there's quite a wide selection, but overall, I would say your 38s, 357s, and 9mm are going to be your best chamberings for something like this, because about a 9mm 38 caliber bullet or cartridge is going to be about this size of a gun in a concealed carry gun, or 6, 7, 8 shot larger snubby. You know, you got a lot of capacity and a good amount of power with those cartridges for a little snub-nosed revolver. Number four, most shooters are not intimidated by something like this when they first pick one up. Now when shooting it, maybe there's going to be a little bit more recoil depending on the caliber, but I've seen this multiple times where people go to the gun store, and I'm going to say particularly women, I've seen multiple women pick up guns like this, and it fits their hands well, and they really like these snub-nosed revolvers because of the way it fits their hands. Just pick them up, hey, this feels comfortable, and they're not intimidated by it because it's a good feel, a good fit, a good size. It's not this long, intimidating barrel. So I've seen multiple women pick up guns like this and say, oh, I like this one. I really like this one. So that's another reason there. You're not intimidated by it. And just by anybody would pick one of these up without being too freaked out. Number five, they're inexpensive when it comes to the alloy framed ones, especially the 38 caliber ones. Now I know revolvers are generally more expensive if you get a high quality one. You know, like my Smith & Wesson 686 was close to $800. And a lot of revolvers are that cost. But when you're talking an alloy frame, something like this, similar to this, you can get something like this, you know, similar guns to this for $300 used, they're still in 95-98% condition. So $300 for a really reliable gun, you know, that's a pretty good price. So they are, in general, inexpensive for your alloy 38 caliber ones or similar caliber ones. Next thing would be a snub-nosed revolver will always be useful for improving your marksmanship skills. These things are difficult to shoot well for most people, but if you can master that double action trigger, you can really shoot any gun well. And with these snubby barrels, You know, it is a little bit difficult to hit a target accurately. Yes, your sight radius is a little bit shorter, non-adjustable sights on most of them, and your biggest issue here is that you don't have a longer barrel that has a lot of steel and weight on the end of it. So anything you do wrong in your trigger pull is going to shake that barrel around as you're firing the gun. That's going to give you not the best accuracy. So if you can work on something like that and you can become a great shot with something like this, that's very useful. That's a very useful reason to have something like this, is it will improve your accuracy with every other handgun you can imagine. So, number 7, reliability. These things are ultra reliable. You're not going to have an issue with these for the most part if you have a well-made one. And certainly if you've taken your snubby revolver out and you've shot it a lot, and you've confirmed it, you know, it's going to cycle. If you're going to have a problem with a revolver, it's going to be something that's not going to be the same thing as a semi-auto. It's not going to have ejection issues and stuff like that, because obviously this doesn't eject. But if you're going to have a problem, you're going to have it within the first few hundred rounds. So if you've put 500 or 1,000 rounds to your revolver, you've verified that thing's going to probably be reliable for the rest of your life. Very reliable. Not only that, but the little snubby barrels, short barrels, I feel like possibly if you ever had an issue where you had a squib round, I feel like it would be less likely in a barrel like this long. You know, that's not really proven, but you know, you got to think, a 4-inch or a 6-inch barrel, you got 2 to 3 times the amount of barrel length that you could have a squibbed round in there if you had a bad round of ammunition. So I would think you'd be less likely to have one, and if you did have one, the next round firing through it only has 2 inches of barrel to push the round that's in there out. Probably going to have less issues with that, with a snubby, than you are with something with a significantly longer barrel, or even semi-automatics with longer barrels. You might have more issue with that than this. That's not proven, but I'm thinking it probably would be less of an issue in something like this. Number 8, it's safe. It's safer. Much safer. These things, very difficult to get a negligent discharge on something like this, especially these double action ones that don't even have a hammer that can, or a hammer spur that you can cock the hammer with. So pretty much the only way to set this gun off is this cylinder has to be free, and this, you know, 12-pound trigger has to be pulled and cycle the whole gun. That's not going to be an issue for most people, and you know, dropping the gun, there's not already a hammer cock back. It is just pretty much your safest firearm you can imagine. Very, very safe. Number 9, it's the most user-friendly gun. If you've ever seen that scene in the movie, I can't remember, it was a Schwarzenegger movie, I think it was a racer, and he gives the gun to the woman and says, you just gotta point and pull the trigger. Pretty much how it is. I mean, these guns, point and pull the trigger. You don't have to know anything about them if it's loaded. If it's not loaded, it means very simple to open up, load it, close it. But if it's loaded, anybody can use it. All you gotta know how to do is pull a trigger. So much more user friendly than really any other gun. I mean, it's the same as a larger revolver, but hey, I'm gonna throw that in this video as well. And my last reason, my 10th reason, is these things are just plain cool. Not a lot of guns have just straight up coolness factors when they come right out of the gun case without even having to modify them, but revolvers, snub-nosed revolvers especially, do. There's something inherently just very cool about it. Got this short, mean-looking barrel and thick cylinder. Oh yeah, coolness factor. Very cool. So that's my 10 reasons why the snub-nosed revolver really is just the handiest gun to have around. They're very small and easy to use. Very easy to conceal. Very easy to pack away somewhere. Very easy to just pick up and throw in your pocket. They're just very handy to have, and they'll always be a use for them. They'll always be able to be used as a backup gun to something better. So, and of course, your marksmanship with something like this. So that's 10 reasons why I think the snub-nosed revolver is the handiest little revolver to have around. And if you ever have one, really, there's no reason to ever get rid of it. It's always going to be useful. It's always going to be handy. And if you can't decide on a good gun for multi-purpose, aside from hunting, you know, snub-nosed revolver would be a great thing to saddle on. So that's my top 10 reasons there, and I hope you enjoyed it. Comment, share, like. As always, thanks for watching.